Look at these two X-rays. Both these patients presented with dyspnea and cough for variable duration. Can you differentiate which one of these patients have diagnosis of interstitial lung disease and which one has pneumonia? Pause this video for a few seconds and look at the X-rays. If you can't differentiate interstitial lung disease from pneumonia with confidence, then this video is for you. Welcome to RADIOCLINICS. In this video, I'll be discussing on different patterns of opacities in an X-ray and how we can approach these opacities and then come to a differential diagnosis. First of all, look at the basic microscopic structure of the lungs. Here we can see the alveoli on both sides and the interstitium in between. Within the interstitium, there run the blood vessels, and here the gaseous exchange in between the alveoli and the interstitium takes place. In a radiograph, the opacities are basically of two types. First type is the communal type and is known as alveolar opacities, which forms when exudate fill up the alveoli. The content that may fill the alveoli may be pus, blood, fluid or cells. As different alveolar sacs communicate to each other in this manner and connect to form a terminal bronchi, the content in the alveoli may also coalesce with each other. These types of opacities are known as alveolar opacities, and these are seen in case of pneumonia when pus fills the alveoli, pulmonary hemorrhage and lung contusions when blood fills the alveoli, and pulmonary edema when fluid fills the alveoli. The next type of opacity is called an interstitial opacity. The interstitial opacities are opacities seen in the connective tissue surrounding the alveoli. They don't coalesce with each other, unlike alveolar opacities, and appear discrete. The difference between alveolar opacities and interstitial opacities can be seen in this table. As we discussed earlier, alveolar opacities tend to coalesce. Interstitial opacities, they do not coalesce and appear discrete. Alveolar opacities have predilection for a particular region of the lung, like a lobe or a segment of a lung, since they coalesce and spread in the pattern. But interstitial opacities, they don't have any particular predilection to a single lobe or segment of a lung, and they tend to be bilateral in distribution and diffuse, involving both the lungs. Alveolar opacities are short-lived opacities. With treatment, they usually show a rapid response. But interstitial opacities are long-lived opacities and they don't show any rapid response to medications. Now look at the different patterns of interstitial opacities. These opacities may occur in the form of nodules, which are rounded opacities or dots, which may be of various sizes and named according to the sizes, like miliary opacities, micronodules and macronodules. And the next form of interstitial opacities are reticules, which are net-like opacities. They are also of various sizes and named according to the sizes. They are fine reticular, medium reticular and coarse reticular types. When nodules and reticules are seen together, then these are known as reticonodular opacities. These are all the types of interstitial opacities. Now take example of these opacities. In the first X-ray, we can see opacity in the right lower zone. This opacity is unilateral and tend to coalesce, forming a patch. It is associated with blunting of the right costophrenic angle. This is an alveolar opacity. So this is a case of pneumonia with small right-sided pleural effusion. Now look at the second X-ray. In the second X-ray, we can see opacities in both the upper zones, more so in the left upper zone. The opacity also tends to coalesce, forming a patch in the left upper zone. This is also an alveolar opacity. This was a case of active pulmonary tuberculosis. Now look at these two X-rays. In both these X-rays, we can see that opacities are bilateral more or less symmetrical, do not coalesce to each other and have net-like pattern. We can see the net-like pattern of opacities here and everywhere. Look at the net-like pattern of opacities in the both lungs. These are interstitial opacities and these both cases are interstitial lung disease. Coming to our query, in the first X-ray we can see multiple net-like opacities in the both lungs which don't tend to coalesce and are bilateral and more or less symmetrical. These are interstitial opacities and this is the case of interstitial lung disease. But in the second X-ray we can see that there are multiple opacities. These opacities tend to coalesce and then form patches. These are bilateral but asymmetrical and these are alveolar opacities. This is a case of viral pneumonia. These two images sum up what you've learned from this video. Interstitial opacities present with nodules or net-like opacities which are discrete, bilateral and more or less symmetrical. This is seen in case of interstitial lung disease. Alveolar opacities on the other hand present with patches and consolidations or coalescing nodules which are more commonly unilateral but may also be bilateral and are usually asymmetrical in appearance. These types of opacities are seen in pneumonia, pulmonary hemorrhage and other diseases that affect the alveoli. Thank you.